blue corner, Benjamin Ankra.
Benjamin Ankra makes his way into the ring, has a record of 9-8 as a professional. From Accra, Ghana, of course, that's Azuma Nelson territory. Azuma, one of the great fighters of all time. And a legendary boxer, Hall of Famer, has his own stadium named for him in Ghana, and is a big hero there. Benjamin Accra making a long journey here to take on.
Now on his way to the ring from the red corner, Antoine Smith.
Big local following here. Brought him in another venue here in South Florida. A couple of fights back from Antoine Smith. Fights a lot locally. In a good way with this kid. Traditionally a slow starter, Glenn. His manager told me that he likes to taste the other guy's power in the first round. Doesn't really do too much. And once he realizes where he stands with that, then he can come on, and he's an extremely dangerous puncher.
Antoine Smith is a talented young guy. I like him a lot. He fought a lot of quality opponents, and I think he have a lot of upside. Very talented kid, real steady in his feet, and throw good combinations.
Antoine Smith, nicknamed the Truth, and we're set for the fighter introductions. Up to the ring, and Bob Alexander.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Hollywood, our next bout of the evening scheduled for 8 rounds of boxing in the welterweight division. Your judges scoring this bout at ringside are Stu Winston, John Rupert, and Bill Ray. Your referee in charge of the action is Frank Gentile. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the brown trunks with the white trim. He weighed at 146 and a quarter pounds. A veteran of 17 professional bouts from Accra, Ghana. Let's welcome Benjamin, the Congo Soldier, Ankra. His opponent fighting out of the red corner, wearing the red trunks with white trim. He weighed at 151 pounds. His professional record, 13 wins, one loss, one draw, with 8 wins by way of knockout. From Miami, Florida, here is Antoine the Truth Smith.
Okay, look, here's the belt line, here's the belt line. Anything below that, I'm gonna call, okay? I gave your instructions in the dressing room. Are there any questions here? Any questions here? All right. When I say break, step back clean, okay? Protect yourself at all times. Punch him up, let's go.
And again, to look at the tail of the tape, the issue was the weight. Antoine Smith weighing in over the limit there at 151. They worked out their differences and were set for this 8-round bout with Ankra. Here we go, round number one of a scheduled 8-rounder. Accra in the maroon trunks with the white trim. Antoine Smith, the local favorite here, in the red trunks with the white stripe. A little bit of that Glenn Johnson peekaboo style from Antoine Smith.
Well, Antoine been in the gym with me, and I'm sure he picked up a few things. He's a talented guy. I like Antoine a lot. He have a lot of upside, a lot of skills, a lot of speed, and solid, strong puncher. Good jab.
Excellent. Nice left jab. Fast pace. Antoine Smith showing some punching ability here in the first round, contrary to some of his previous fights where we got off to an exceptionally slow start.
Alexi is a smart fighter too. He's throwing smart counterpunch. He's waiting to throw the counterpunch in, but he needs to set it up off the jab, which is he used the jab right there, a good right hand over the top. So he's a smart fighter. He's not just here to lay down for Antoine. Antoine has to dot his eyes and cross his T's. You know, he's in here with a short, strong guy, and this guy is not laying down for him.
They're exchanging some heavy leather, even though most of the activity has been jabbing. These are some serious jabs with some steam on them.
Oh, yeah, they're throwing some serious leather. Those jabs have serious shoulder behind it, and there's good hand speed from both of these guys. You know, Antoine is he's faster than him, definitely, but at the same time, he's using good timing to get his punches in.
That's about 2 minutes gone in the first round, and Hayes has been quick here with these two young welterweights. Antoine Smith, just the one loss on his resume. Took on an undefeated fighter a couple of fights back and really showed him the door. After getting off to a slow start, he was getting hammered around the ring and scored a fourth round TKO. Very impressive performance there. Benjamin Ankrow, as you said, though, looks to have some solid fundamental skills and a good combination of body shots so far in the first round.
Yeah, Benjamin is he's a solid guy. He's you know, he got decent fundamentals and he's a counter puncher. You can see he's looking to throw the right hand over the jab. He's looking to throw the jab right after Antoine throw his jab, and he's leading with this jab as well. So you know, he's staying low, he's staying underneath the punches. You know, he's not sticking his head up. You know, he's making himself solid. You know, he got his back leg in a good position to keep his balance. So this is a good fight.
Final 10 seconds, now inside of 5 seconds. Round number one, scheduled for 8.
Five.
And an interesting first round for a round that you thought was going to be somewhat of a feeling out process, Clint Johnson. You get a look in the corner of Benjamin Ankrow, a long way from Accra, Ghana. And once again, a guy that looks like a 500 fighter, 9-8 coming in, and showed us a lot more skill than that record would indicate.
As you can see here, Benjamin using his jab, and Antoine is using his. He looked for the body shot, he didn't land it clean, and they go right by the exchange jabs. And this is a tight fight. It, you know, both of these guys is evenly talented. Antoine have the speed over him, but that's just it. That's pretty much it. Everything else is pretty equal. Both of them smart fighters and exchanging punches.
Not an easy round to score. I'm going to give a slight edge in that round to Antoine Smith. I thought he worked the jab a little bit more effectively. And of the two, landed
fight.
A little bit more powerful shots than did Benjamin Ankrow. You can make a case for the kid from Ghana also. Here's the second round, scheduled 8-rounder. In the red trunks is Antoine Smith. Has a tendency to pick up the pace as the fight progresses. He's very confident in there. These exchanges are very even.
Well, man, this is a beautiful combination from both of these guys. Both of them is confident in themselves. And they throw a good combination. There's no feeling out process. They're throwing wicked punches to do damage. And this is a crowd pleasing fight. This is great stuff.
Feeling out process has been expedited. Antoine Smith taking it into the phone booth there for a second. A little bit more posing than he did punching. But it looks like both fighters are comfortable inside and outside.
Well, Antoine have a bad habit that I don't like. You see him drop his hand right there and kind of try to use his elbow to create distance. And that's something he's been doing for a while now. But, you know, he get away with it because he haven't been in the ring with somebody who throws short right hands. But this is a guy who is built compact. So, you know, let's see if this guy know how to throw short right hand. You see him try to do it right there. But, you know, we'll see what happens. This is a tight fight. Both of these guys are talented. Antoine have the hand speed, and he's establishing that. And, you know, these are great exchanges.
Midway through round number two, excellent body work in this round by Antoine Smith. He's been concentrating on the body, although it looks like Benjamin Ankrow is an anchor when it comes to the body. Like he's a brick wall, and seems to be weathering the body attack fairly well. Good uppercut inside. Antoine Smith misses with a couple of shots. Now pinned against the ropes as Ankrow comes forward. Putting pressure on Antoine Smith now as we're approaching the final minute of the second round.
Yeah, Benjamin's starting to slow down. He's starting to slow down now. I think the pace of the fight's starting to get to him. And a lot of the power and snap off his punches is kind of diminished. He's now starting to push his shots. And they're not as snappy, they're not as fast anymore. Antoine now starting to turn to pull away, you know, with talent. He's landing his punches, he's pulling away, and now Benjamin is just missing. He's not landing, he's not doing any damage anymore.
almost exclusively focused on the body to Antoine Smith. You got to figure that's going to pay some dividends later on. Now, it looks a little bit like Mike McCallum, the body snatcher in there. And this is something that you also like to see in a young kid. You like to see a young kid make progress like Smith has and also be an effective body punch.
Yeah, I like to see you mix it up. When you're in the ring, you got to mix up your punches because it kind of confuses the defense of your opponent because you don't really know where you're going next. A good combination right there. So this is a good tight fight. I like it.
And for rallying as we come to the close of round two. Well, in spite of that last flurry by Benjamin Ankrum, I thought that was a much better round overall for Antoine Smith. Really took the play away from Ankrum with all those body shots that he used in the first couple of games.
Yeah, he's starting to break him down with the body work. Here you can see the tight work between the two guys, good exchange. Antoine get into that little peekaboo style where he bend over that hand, he make Benjamin make a wild swing, and Antoine making him pay with the body work.
A couple of rounds in the bank for Antoine Smith. First one, no, might could have gone either way. Big fan of the even round.
Seconds out.
You could have made that first round even.
Seconds out.
So we have a very tight fight here as we go to round number three.
Bucks.
It was a body attack of Antoine Smith that told the story in round number two. See what kind of strategy he employs here as we start out round number three. Going upstairs now with the jab. Good work inside now by Antoine Smith, starting to hammer away at the head. He's come upstairs here in round three, Glenn.
Yeah, Antoine is doing good work. He's doing a lot of shoulder whirl and getting away from a lot of the punch from Benjamin. But Benjamin is slowed down now and basically looping punches and not being successful, while Antoine throwing nice, sharp punches. Beautiful combination. They got a right hand over the top that Benjamin been looking for over that shoulder. Because Antoine have a bad habit of dropping that left hand and pick up the elbow, trying to.
Got that Floyd Mayweather posture there. He tries to roll his shoulder and use it as a defensive mechanism. Now missing his shots, trying to counter off the ropes. And Benjamin Ankrum, for the moment at least, will seize the momentum.
And Ray Jones is another guy who do the same thing. I remember when he and I was fighting, he was doing that a lot, just pick up that shoulder and pick up the elbow. But I was able to get close and throw the right hand over the top and was successful. Let's see what happened here.
Momentarily, from the southpaw stance, was Antoine Smith comes back, tries to fire off a couple of shots to the body that score. But it doesn't appear that it's advantageous for him to lean back against the ropes. Stuck in the corner now, being pressed by Benjamin Ankrum.
He's throwing nice, short, inside punches. But again, you know, his flaw is having that left hand down. And I think he's trying to use that left hand right there to protect himself from body shots. But, you know, he needs to protect himself from that overhand right. He's trying to hide behind his shoulder and protect himself from the overhand right and keep his left hand down to protect himself from the body shot.
Use another good elbow. Exchange in the corner. Antoine Smith, the truth, being warned by Frank Gentile in the ring, about to use the elbow. Benjamin Ankrum having a good start two-thirds of the way through this third round, scheduled for eight rounds. Again, we see Antoine Smith, the dangerous tactic, dropping that left hand.
It's hard for him not to do it because that's what he practices in the gym. Is his style, is what he's like to do. But I think at some point in time he got to pay with somebody who knows to throw a right hand over the shoulder, a short right hand over the top. But you know, for now he's been successful with it.
Ankrum starting to steal the thunder away a little bit in this third round. I think it's going to be decided in this final 20 seconds. Smith has been there, but he's also been tagged a few times.
Well, Smith is doing the better work, but the reason why Benjamin is getting back in the fight is because of Smith's lack of defense.
5 seconds to go. Coming to the close in round number three.
Time.
I like the way Benjamin Ankrum finished that round. In general, there's a rule of thumb in scoring, Glenn, that you try to break it down. Arthur Mercanni had this in 1 minute seconds. Smith was right there for the first 2 minutes. Yeah. Now the toss, a 10-9 round for Benjamin Ankrum in round number three.
I would do the same thing because you know, Smith leave himself open to get those shots out. And when you get hit clean with those punches, a lot of times you can sway the judges your way.
You got to look at Ankara in the corner. First couple rounds, a little bit troubling for him, and we thought maybe he was getting tired in that second round as he was getting hammered to the body by Antoine Smith. But a resilient bounce
Check
back
down.
And resurrected his chances of winning this fight in the third round.
Stay in the corner, please. Box.
Here we go, round number four. I have it 2-1 for Antoine Smith. Smith working the jab substantially and scoring significantly with it. And Benjamin Ankara pressing the action, coming forward and constant pressure. And a good combination. Most of those blocked, but the right hand might have grazed it.
Well, Antoine can do so much better if he step around like he's doing here, create distance. Once you create distance, then Benjamin can't get to him because Benjamin does not have the talent and the speed to keep up with him. The time when Benjamin gets successful is when they get him close. When Antoine get right there where he drop his hand and lean in, and Benjamin is able to run off 2 or 3 punches and score with
him. Right hand that time finds the mark as a lead weapon. Ankara continuing to press forward. Firing first. Antoine Smith doing a good job. Clever job of counterpunching this one.
Definitely, the rule of thumb is if you're faster than your opponent, you do the guy that need to create space where you can use your hand speed. When you're the slower man, you want to take away space where you can use power. So, you know, and that's what Benjamin doing, and Antoine kind of helped him in the third round, helping being successful by being close. Right here, he's creating the space and he's able to use his hand speed and doing wonderfully so far.
Tattoo and Ankara with the jab. Here in the first half of round number four, Ankara trying to fire back now and answer. Smith doing a better job defensively, slipping punches with some subtle head movement also.
Yeah, what you don't want to do is lean in there. See, they take a big right hand right there. You don't want to lean in there if you are Antoine and trying to exchange punches or trying to let Benjamin get a chance to throw those counter punches. You want to create the distance where you can show your hand speed and let everyone see how clearly you're winning the fight.
You have to question Ankara's punching power because Antoine Smith just locked himself right into a right hand. Got hit almost flush on the cheekbone with it, and Ankara was just one knockout. Seems like he's unable to hurt Antoine Smith, even though he's thrown some serious left.
Well, he's a strong guy. You have to build as a puncher. But, you know, when you build like that, a lot of times when you go rounds, you start to get weak. You know, your body doesn't get enough oxygen, so you start to weaken. And that's what you want to do. Take a muscle guy into the late rounds and see if you could get him weakened. And again, Antoine with his low hands, by a big right hand over the top.
Seems to be getting a better sense of timing, Ankara, as he advances forward. Antoine Smith, and then a couple of pulverizing shots. Ankara tries to answer back, misses both of those. Chase a left hand at the end of that exchange. 10 seconds to go, round number four, reaching the midway point of the scheduled 8-rounder. Got a good one brewing here at the Hard Rock Live.
Time.
After being a little suspect in round number three, and I scored that round for Ankara, round number three, but round four, Antoine Smith reestablished his superiority in this fight.
He created distance, and that's what he needs to do in this fight. Create distance to show his talent. Anytime you allow Benjamin to get close, Benjamin will be able to throw those punches over the top.
Right hand. I'm open to
coming up here, in the replay, you're going to see what I'm talking about with Antoine having his hands low. And as you're right here saying, throwing the jab, they're exchanging jab, exchanging punches. And you know, just after that exchange right there, there's a right hand over the top by Benjamin. Because Smith is keeping that left hand low.
Stay in the corner. Box.
All right, here we go. Second half of this one. Good scrap going so far. I have Antoine Smith up 3-1. First round was debatable, and the pace has been wicked. And it continues to be a very fast-paced fight with Antoine Smith, again, coming back with the jab, trying to reestablish that as the main weapon here in round 5.
Antoine needs to double up his jab. He's throwing one punch at a time. And he'd need to double up that jab so he can create space for the right hand. So, you know, instead of throwing a one jab, throw a two. And then right there, he should have dropped the right hand over the top. Good exchange.
Excellent
between the
flurry
two
there. Both guys landing significant shots.
This is where Antoine don't want to be, right there. You don't want to be right here, because here you allow Benjamin to throw punches. He's a slow guy, and you're giving him a chance to land punches because he's so close to you. You need to create the distance where you can show yourself, your ability to hit him and get out of the way before you respond.
Anchor trying to work his way inside. At a disadvantage when it comes to reach. Trying to cut the distance on Antoine Smith. Smith trying his best to make him pay. Misses with an uppercut. Catches a grazing right hand that time from Anchor, who's still very much alive in this fight. Smith initiating the action off the ropes. Smith won his first five fights. Incurred his only loss in his sixth bout as a professional. Lost to a guy with 11-2 at the time. And continues to grow. Learning the lessons of what it takes to be successful in a professional ring. Body work there.
Right here on the ropes, Antoine don't need to be there. You know, you're allowing Benjamin to look good now. He's throwing the combination, but it's hard. When you go in a fight like this, it's hard to tell who is winning when you hit the man and he hits your right back and you're not establishing any power punch to separate yourself from him. You know, and Antoine have the skills to not to be where he is right now with Benjamin. He's giving Benjamin a chance.
Not a lot to separate the two. Antoine Smith throwing the bigger punches, wider shots. I would agree with you, Glenn. I don't think the ropes are necessarily a safe haven for Antoine Smith in this fight. If the action's in the center of the ring, he seems to be in control.
Hey, he definitely don't need the ropes. It's not like he's hurt and he need the rope to help him, to hold him up. What he needs to do is keep on throwing his jab and slide back a little bit, slide to the left, slide to the right. And when he create distance like he just did, he's to throw combinations.
Suddenly Ankara not punching, not putting out any punch output. Now he fires. Antoine Smith tries to counter.
Watch using that elbow.
He's back on the ropes, gets a warning from the referee, Gentile, about the elbow. 10 seconds to go. Quick paced fight here. Heading for the sixth round of a 7-8 rounder.
Time.
Not a big margin between these two guys. I still have Antoine Smith on a round-by-round basis.
Angus now, Angus now. Hit it here, go here. When you hit it here, Angus, bam! Defend.
Angra had his moments.
Okay? Remember, when you hit it, upper cool. Move your head first and hit it.
This is where he's on the ropes right here, where I didn't like him. And you can see Antoine is throwing some good shot. Benjamin is doing good body work. And they see the exchange between both of them. Right there is an even exchange between two guys. And this is what you don't want happening if you're Antoine, because you have the talent to separate yourself from exchanging.
Ready to go.
To step out on the outside, use your hand speed, and use that distance.
Second
to separate yourself.
Stay in your corner, okay? Stay in your corner. Stay in your corner. Wipe some of that grease off. Wipe some of that grease off. Time. Time. Wipe
right,
the grease off.
Stop it here.
Wipe
for
his
a second
grease off.
As Benjamin Ankara, a little too much Vaseline
give me
on
that,
the face.
Give me that time. Wipe that grease off.
I like the effectiveness
of
the taking
wipe
of command
off
of Frank Gentile. Not putting up with any nonsense.
Okay.
He takes charge himself.
Go.
Good fight brewing here, though, and it's been
time
that way
in.
Since the opening bell. Very competitive. Round number six of a scheduled 8 rounder. Antoine Smith, a local kid. Hails from right here in Miami. As you said, Glenn, you've worked with him in the gym. A guy with some skills. Looks like he has some athleticism also, like he might be able to be successful in other sports. And Benjamin Ankara. And about that is Zuma Nelson School. Typical posture that you see from fighters from Ghana. Tough kid inside, and still very much alive in this one.
Oh, yeah. Benjamin is a tough candidate. He's not going away easy. He's a strong guy, and, you know, he's here to win. And Benjamin is not clowning. He's throwing good, solid body shots. good work. Antoine is giving him an opportunity whenever time he let him get on the inside. And he's got to stay on the outside using his jab, doubling up those jabs like he's doing right here. Put the right hand down and go on the body shot.
Outstanding exchange there. Both guys
exactly. You got to slide out. You got to bend his knees and slide out. Antoine,
keep your punches up. Get him up.
Good work.
Gets tagged that time. Ankara coming up with a nice combination. Got it with the left, came upstairs with the right. Pressing the action for the last several rounds. Antoine Smith now flashing a right hand. Still holding his hands low. Did a good job of ducking punches. Nice lead jab that time with a good counter. By Ankara.
Very good exchange. This is a great fight.
If you like inside trench work, this has been a beauty.
Nice
combination that
beautiful
time.
Beautiful combination by Benjamin. You come back with a hook and land a clean, and that's what happens when you're on the inside with a guy who needs to be on the inside to be successful.
Smith tries to answer back once again, finds himself on the tough turf as he's backed up against the ropes. Inside the final minute of round number six. This one picking up the pace, and the suspense is also picking up in his fight. Antoine Smith that time with a good exchange.
A beautiful combination from Antoine. But, you know, if he create distance, he get more opportunity to do that. And right now, he's on the inside, and Benjamin going to do the better work.
Another difficult round to score as we approach 20 seconds left to go in this sixth round. Both guys appear to have their legs underneath them, and both still firing shots with regularity and incredible volume.
Ooh, beautiful work from both guys. You can see the determination to win the fight.
Time!
And there was the bell. A good flurry at the end of that sixth round. Antoine's on the judgment. Maybe get some
we'll turn him around.
Yeah, he's really when you're on the inside and you're on the ropes, you're gonna see where these guys gonna exchange combination, and it's suit Benjamin a lot better than it suit Antoine, because on the inside Benjamin could lean, find him, know where he is, and run off those combinations. Antoine is a little more mobile, as you can see here, while Antoine on the outside, he can throw those combinations. Once Benjamin feel him, he start throwing those punches. Once he feel him lean on him, he start throwing combinations. Right here.
Seconds out!
Good combination right here by Benjamin, and Antoine is coming back with good combination as well. And you can see the exchange between the two guys.
Round number seven, scheduled for eight. These two young guys, these could well be considered championship rounds. Heck of a show so far by both fighters. Neither fighter's been down, neither fighter has been cut. Neither guy's really been seriously hurt so far in this fight, and that may be the one thing that works against Ankara. While he's had some spectacular exchanges towards the end of a couple of the rounds, he's unable to quite put that exclamation point on. Something that would do enough damage to put Smith in trouble. He got a big shot in there, though. Smith's starting to show some signs of wear and tear.
Ankara's picking it up right now. Ankara's picking it up. He's going fast combination now. So
combination. The pace of this fight has been incredible, and it's, as we said, they don't need a whole lot of room to work these things out.
Ankara pick up his hand speed right here. He threw a nice combination. I tell you, once he get close, he know how to throw those punches.
War breaking out inside the ring. Good boy down to the age-old question of who wants it more, who has something left in the tank. Pull this thing out of the fire. Ankara again putting the pressure on
shoulder.
Antoine Smith.
I'll use that shoulder.
And as we said, this has been familiar territory, but some dangerous stuff for Antoine against the ropes. Good, sweet little left hand inside by Antoine Smith.
Yeah, is he throwing good combination, both these guys? Doing wonderful combinations, and this is what you want to see, is good quality fight, and this is what this is. You got two guys in here who believe they're going to win, and they can win, and they're establishing themselves like that.
The right hand's trying to roll to his right, is Antoine Smith. Again, left hand, countering off the ropes by Antoine Smith. Tries the uppercut inside. That misses. Ankara continuing to come forward. Not punching as effectively as he was earlier on.
He's staying close now. Right now, he's just buying time. He's trying to rest.
Let him go.
He's not doing the combination. He's just trying to stay close. And I believe Antoine can give himself some room and really take advantage of Benjamin not being ready to punch.
Smith firing punches and punches.
He's throwing good combinations right now.
Anchor coming on, trying to buy some time here so he can get his hands going. Outstanding action right above us here in the corner. 15 seconds to go here in round number 7.
Anchor is holding on now, trying to buy time. And this is where Smith needs to start establishing himself.
10 seconds to go. Looks like this one's going to be decided in the 8th and final round. Excellent battle between two young stars.
Time.
Wow. That was another tough one. I think this fight in favor of Smith, and my story might be a little bit off, a little lopsided. I have pointed five or seven rounds.
Last round, touch
gloves. Very debatable. This is
an
easy fight to score. Depends what you like.
I mean, again, it's hard to say.
Last round, touch gloves.
These are close rounds. A lot of these rounds are close. It all depends on what the judge is like.
All right, here we go. Action from round number 7, Glenn. And this is sweet.
You see the good body work from both guys. Punches over the shoulder. Benjamin is throwing those punches over the shoulder, and this is where him having his hands down, Antoine, he's paying for
down,
it.
And
Antoine is doing good work as well, but the difference is the right hand over the top by Benjamin.
Here we go, the 8th and final round. This battle may be very much undecided and still up in the air on the judges' scorecards. Antoine Smith out of Miami, Florida, 13-1-1, and Benjamin Ankara, who came in with a 9-8 record with just one knockout, putting on a whale of a show here in front of the people at the Hard Rock Live.
It's a beautiful fight. Both guys have good discipline, good boxing skills. Antoine have a little bit more far as speed is concerned and instinct, but Benjamin is throwing good punches and good timing and getting close and doing good work. As you can see here, good uppercut from Antoine, good body shot. And he's sliding back. This is what I like to see him do. Slide back and create those room and pick him and pick Benjamin apart.
The uppercut scores. It gets Anchor's attention here. Antoine Smith off to a quick start in the 8th and final round. This could be decisive stuff. This fight has been exceedingly close. Could make a case for either guy. Smith getting the better of it now, though. Hammering away at the head with uppercuts, short left hooks. Again, pressed up against the ropes.
Good body work.
Excellent two-punch combination.
Those left hands to the head and to the body is a beautiful thing.
First minute of the final stanza. Oh, Antoine Smith, Anchor still there though, making his presence felt. Can he find the energy to get off some punches and maybe pull this fight out of the back? Smith again with the uppercuts. Now he's hurting him to the body. Minute and a half to go in this fight. Pace has been just like this, electrifying right from the start. If you're a fan of good inside fighting and counterpunching, you have to love this.
Oh, I love good right hand over the top. You see Benjamin put that hand right there. You don't want to catch that right hand again.
Antoine Smith looking to pull this one out. Leave no doubt on the judges' scorecards. Having a big 8th round. Minute to go. Anchor from Ghana, as he has throughout the fight, almost like Joe Frazier trying to pocket him inside. Certainly firing with less frequency. Antoine Smith putting on a show here in round number 8. Left hand scores. Anchor comes back.
Yeah, it's a beautiful fight, man. I love to see the exchange. I love to see the way how these guys are thinking. You can see their thinking, trying to create the opportunity to land their punches. Beautiful right hand over the top by Antoine.
Excellent inside work in the 8th round by Antoine Smith. Black back by Anchor. Anchor coming on now. 20 seconds to go. Who wants to win this one? Antoine Smith showboating a little bit. Great performance by both fighters. They slug it out to the wire. 10 seconds to go. Smith against the ropes. Oh, he's beaten.
This is the type of fight you want to see. You don't mind seeing these two guys fight each other again. This is great action fight.
Two breaks the whole fight.
I'm just talking to the corner about the fighter held on. I mean, straight up back all the way through. My scorecard might be a little bit out of whack. I wouldn't be embarrassed if I was off on this one.
Good fight.
I had Antoine Smith winning 6 of the 8 rounds. I thought he did an outstanding job in the final round. Really put his stamp on his fight. I think he's going to win the decision, maybe by unanimous fashion, but maybe a little bit closer than I have.
I think it might be a little bit closer than you have it, but I still believe Antoine will win the majority rounds and he should win this fight. He closed out the fight beautifully in the last round with beautiful combinations, sliding back like I would like to see him do more throughout the fight, but nevertheless, I believe that he did enough to be successful. Good exchange right here. Antoine is putting a right hand over the top. He's establishing the hook right there. And he's throwing one punch and slide out and try to slide back in just when Benjamin commit himself a little bit too much. Right here you can see where Benjamin now is being successful, start landing some punches, and he's beating Antoine to it. Using his proper timing and
center
catching Antoine. A beautiful
center
exchange between the two guys.
The
and it's a beautiful fight.
I see both guys deserving of any liquid refreshment and a rest. I think we're set with the scorecards tabulated. Let's throw it up to the ring. And Bob Alexander.
Watch out.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Hollywood, after 8 rounds of boxing, we go to the scorecards. Judges Stu Winston and John Rupert both score the bout 77-75. Judge Bill Ray scores the bout 79-73. For the winner by unanimous decision, Antoine the Truth Smith.
Well, the local kid hears the chorus of blues. I don't think you can do anything but applaud either fighter for that one. I did have it closer to the third judge, right at 79-73. They were very close rounds, not necessarily exceedingly decisive, and I thought Antoine Smith got the better of it. And if you were looking at the fight overall, I thought he did the better job.
Well, you know, both guys could make an argument about this fight. They did a wonderful job. Again, you see good talent between both guys, and both of them can make an argument about who won the fight.